I'm Tarmakar, and welcome to Food of Busy Kitchens, where I speak to you about the food cooked in the kitchens across Mumbai from different communities. Today I'm going to speak to you about Tamil food cooked by a Tamil home chef who was born in Mumbai. Her name is Meena Subramanian, and she has an enterprise called Perima's Kitchen, where she does Tamil food. And Perima, from what I understand from Meena, means aunt, like a barima. Yeah, so it's more metaphorical. But before I tell you about the food, and this is the second time I'm tasting her food. Early on, I tried her tiffin, the morning Tamil sort of tiffin, and it was lovely as well. This sort of lovely brunch. But before that, I'm going to let you into a secret. So I grew up in Kolkata in the 1980s, and I must confess that at that time, we would refer to everyone from the south of India as Madrasi. So it was not right, and I think that with time we've sort of learned to appreciate the fact. But in fact, we had our friends and neighbors in Narasimhan's, lovely family, and they were actually from Kerala, and every Diwali they would get these lovely snacks and so on. But I think it's when I moved into Mumbai in the late 1990s that I got to meet people from different communities in India. When I began my work in market research, a lot of my colleagues were from South India. Well, I got to try varieties of South Indian food in Mumbai before I began to travel to other parts of the country. And one began to learn and understand and appreciate the diversity which is there to South Indian food. When we were growing up, we thought that South Indian means Madrasi, and all Madrasi food is only idli, bara, dosa. And I'm not sure that while I'm confessing that, I'm not the only one who is that. So when I came to Mumbai, then I got exposed to Keralite food. When I went to Fort and in places like Tilak's or Taste of Kerala and Lalit and even and Ramania and so on. And about the sadhyas there and the buff parathas, the mutton pepper fry, the parathas and the fish curries and the Malabar biryanis and so on. Then, the fresh food, the seawater fish places in Mumbai, Apurva, Mahesh, one learned with time that these are actually Mangalorean food. And later I got to travel to Cochin in Kerala, to Bangalore in Karnataka and try the food over there. I went to Bangalore and tried the food there. Vijayawada, which is so different from what you get here. We don't get much of Andhra food in Mumbai, but I got to try that when I went to Vizag, when I went to Hyderabad, and of course Hyderabadi food. Now, what about Madrasi food? Because Madras is what is now known as Chennai, the capital of Tamil Nadu. In fact, my friend Shivala, who does a lot of Sangam food, which is the history of South Indian food and emanated during the Sangam era. You don't actually get much of that in Mumbai, because most of the South Indian places, vegetarian places in Mumbai, are actually run by people from the Shetty community from Mangalore, and the food which you get there is what you get in the temple town of Udupi, where I happened to go last year, and I went to a place called Mitra Cafe at Udupi and tried the Goli Bhajje, which is very famous over there, and the Masala Dosa and so on, and of course the Garbar ice cream, which was invented in Udupi. But you don't actually get much Tamil food commercially in Mumbai today. At the most, there are the cycle walas who come with medu varas and idlis and so on. Many of them are Tamil. In fact, my book, The Travelling Belly, has the picture of a Tamil gentleman who sells medu varas in a stall at Bandra East and lovely stuff. So it's really thanks to the home chefs that we're getting a taste of this. So Meena Subramanian is born in Mumbai, but her parents were in the 90s, came to Mumbai from Tirunelveli in Tamil Nadu. And the food which she offers in Perima's kitchen is the sort of food which they cook at home and which her parents eat. In fact, a lot of her material, like the rasam and the sambar powder and the heen, is sourced from Tirunelveli. In fact, the gingerly oil which she uses is actually sourced from their original village. And the sort of food which I've eaten here, and this is the second time that I'm having it, it reminds me of the food which I've had in South India. Incidentally, it's not that easy to find Tamil food in Chennai as well. You'll get the biryani places, you'll get the Ambur biryani and the Dindigul biryani and so on. But when you go for vegetarian, a lot of those places, even in Chennai, are Shetty run. You know, famous places like Woodlands and so on. But there's also a very nice place for medu varas and idlis in Chennai. And I'm trying to remember his name, I'll post it in the comments. But this is like beautiful, lovely, clean food, the flavors, they're very light, very diverse, and uses, there's a lot of rice-based products used over here, and there's a lot of freshness to it. So in the next segment, I'm going to take you through the food, what we're having today. But I must say that last time the food was so good, when we tried the rasam varas and the idlis and things like that, that the next day we ordered a couple of boxes for our friend and his parents, and they loved it as well. So I'm really grateful and thankful for people making the effort to take food from their home kitchens and offering it to us, just as Meena has in Perima's kitchen. Barima's kitchen, like she says, in translated, or auntie's kitchen, because it's sort of brought such lovely, beautiful, pure and sincere food into our kitchens. And you saw me sort of plating the kalapatta banana leaf. In fact, in Calcutta as a kid, you know, we used to eat in banana leaves in weddings and so on. Even in Parsi weddings, I've come and experienced that. And since I've had her food before and banana leaves, and also Marina Palakrishnan's Uttapura, the Keralite food, and you've seen that before. So I've slowly learned. So I'm sorry if I got anything wrong, but I believe from what I plated last time, some readers wrote to me that the heavier elements are supposed to be on the broader size of the banana leaf, and the smaller elements, or the fried elements, are on the smaller side. So I've got it right. I'm learning, and as I learn, I keep sharing it with you.
Let me tell you about the food. Meena has very kindly sent descriptions of everything. So I'm going to read through that. There's semia payasam, which is vermicelli milk pudding, as she puts it, and slow cooked. A small banana. We call this ilaichi kela in Mumbai. Then there are two sorts of what I'm guessing are dumplings. Now, I might get the pronunciation wrong, but it's a very interesting one. It's a sweet koza katai. I've just broken this to show you the filling, which is jaggery and coconut with pieces of jackfruit, and it's steamed in rice flour. So we have Chinese dim sums and dumplings. Well, this is an Indian one, and the flavors of jackfruit really come through. And then there's a savory one, which is made with upma or broken rice. And this is called upma koza katai, which is broken rice, sauteed with mustard, green chili and dry coconut, and made into these little dumplings. And it reminds me of the way my mother would make me eat rice as a kid. She would make them into little round balls and call them kaket dim, piara dim, which means like crow egg, parrot egg, and so on. And then this is one of my favorite dishes, which ironically I first had in Bangalore, in Karnataka, not Tamil Nadu, at Veena Kitchen. And it's in Maleshwaram, or was it Koramangalam? I think in Maleshwaram. And it's called Puliyodre. It's a beautiful thing. Rice made in tamarind. It's tamarind rice with peanuts, and you have it with fritters. So the fritters are called Marachini Appalam, and there is tapioca papar and rice fritters. Then there are mini idlis. So just to give you a perspective, by the way, there was more food. I've taken enough for one person. The chutney, fresh coconut chutney, which you have with the idlis. And then there's one more rice dish. I've never heard of this before. It's called Tenga Sadam, which is, according to Meena, sauteed with fresh coconut, tempered with mustard, chili and curry leaves. So I think I have done a reasonably good job or justice to the fabulous food on offer. Like I said, there's far more food, and I'm going to eat. I'm going to serve some to Kanas too.
Rukmani, Rukmani, akkam pakkam enta shatam.
So I just finished a sumptuous lunch, and I realized that you might be more interested in the food than about my experience with Tamilian food or South Indian food and all that. This banana I'm keeping for later, do I? And I must tell you, at the end of the meal, as I was packing up, I discovered a pleasant surprise. There were little pori idlis with pori and gingerly oil on it, which was there below the banana leaf in the box. So I know what I'm going to have in the evening. But Perima, Meena, whatever you want to call yourself, this is one lovely meal. And in a way, this meal and my enjoyment of it reflects one's growing up in the early days when one tried South Indian vegetarian food when I'd even gone to the parents of my friend's house. I don't think I'd really enjoyed it at that point, because I don't think
my mind was that open to experimenting, but I think over the years it has, and which is beautiful because one has learned to enjoy the goodness of food. So let me tell you, man, this food was brilliant. The idlis, since I started talking about the idlis, so soft. And imagine they cooked it when, and then it came to our house, and when one shot and ate, so soft, like, you know, baby loaf's cheeks, and that fresh coconut chutney with that. And the little upma sort of dumplings, you know, I've never had something like that. I'm going to have a bit of that in the evening as well. And so much, so full of flavor, even though it was not had piping hot. And then what else? There was the puliore. It was so nice, the tamarind flavors, and not too sharp, and the soft peanuts in it, slightly crunchy, was beautiful. And the other, the thenga sadam, the rice which is cooked with freshly grated coconut and mustard seeds, was a revelation. And the sambar which we had is very different from what one gets in Udipi restaurants. This is not sweet. This was on the thicker side, and it was you know, packed with pumpkin and drumsticks, and it's like a par boost, like a magic potion. Then of course the fritters, the rice fritters, the murukus, the papas, everything was very nice. And what else? The dahi vada. So I told Kainaz that you should also try some of the dahi vada. She was trying some of the food, and she never likes dahi vada. I said, try it, because it's going to be different from the Punjabi and the Gujarati one. And so, you know, I tried a little trick. I said that when you're having it, imagine it's a Turkish dessert, or like a Turkish salad rather, not dessert. And it was so good. You know, the slight, the tangy hit of curd, the little pomegranate which added the sweetness to it, medu vada, which we all love, and the spicing. It was, and I must tell you about the sweet dumpling. Remember the one with stuffed with coconut and jaggery and jackfruit? So in a sense, it's a bit like, in a sense, like the ukreche modak, which one has in Maharashtra. But I must say that the rice flour coating was a lot thinner, and very, very juicy filling. So I had two or three of them. I didn't intend to have so many. And the payasam, the semolina payasam, it reminded me of my childhood, because it was really about the taste of milk, and there was a bit of shor in that, the skin of the milk or the malai. As a kid, one would spit it out, but I enjoyed it. It really brought memories of my childhood, but in a nice way. As a kid, I used to run away from milk, but this I like, because this is slow cooked and simmered, so it's more like a pie, so one like that. So so Meena, you've got one Bengali and also a Parsi, fairly smitten by your vegetarian Tamil food from Tirunelveli, and that's quite a bit of a task. And thank you, and guys, I did a full chete pute. I hope I'm wrapping it right. Wait, so before I say goodbye to you, I'm gonna have my soft idli, the one with pori from Meena's. And I hope I'm wrapping the banana leaf right, because last time someone said that there's a significance of whether you liked it or not depending on which side you're rolling it from. So guys, I mean, I hope I did it right, but even if I didn't, symbolically, I loved this lunch. Thank you, Meena. Come back on.